We had snow again, so that's no fun, but it didn't stop all the games from being played, so that was nice.
Yes. The Republic Bank LIT being one of them, held over at Valley with several of the top area schools participating, and in the first matchup, Bullet East taking on Fern Creek. We'll pick it up in the first quarter. Joe Jackson will launch from deep from way downtown, bang, and Fern Creek takes a 5-point lead. Back the other way for Bullet East, Brett Troutman will step up and hit the free throw line jumper, and the Chargers are down 3. Now more from Bullet East. Tyler Sharp, the nice drive and the up and under move for the score. Chargers down 1, but still in the first. Sean Best will connect on the deep 2 from the wing. Fern Creek up 3. So let's move to the second quarter now. Trey Cook knocks down the tray from the corner. That puts Fern Creek up 6, and then later in the quarter back the other way again. Look how deep Tyler Sharp is. He connects from downtown, and Bullet East is down 3. Then the Chargers on the break. Bailey Ricks up ahead to Brendan Clefford for the layup. Fern Creek would be your winner, though, advancing to the semifinals with a 55-52 win.
You know, Bullet East is a tough program. It's a program that's been on top for a long time. And for our kids that listen to the scouting report, that worked hard every day of practice to prepare for this game, it's just monumental for our school. It's really, really big. We'll get back tonight. We'll let them rest. We won't have much of a shoot-around time because you got to turn right back around. But again, I tell our kids, you know, think big. Again, we know where we're at right now. We have to improve every day. But if we are blessed enough late in the year to mount something, the state tournament setup is just like the LIT. So it's a great preparation for that.
Second game of the night had PRP taking on St. X. First quarter, Robert Shaw with the drive, and he gets it to fall. St. X up 1. Later in the first, now Deshaun Russian knocks down the 3 from the top of the key, and the Panthers take a 3-point lead. More from Russian and the Panthers. The kick out, he's open in the corner, buries the triple, and PRP takes a 6-point lead. Time winding down in the half. The feed to Austin Chambers from the corner. That is good. PRP takes the win 67-52, and will meet Fern Creek in the semifinals.
This has been coming a little while. You know, we haven't played, like Jay said, we haven't played real well for an entire basketball game this year. For what reason, we don't understand. But we're seeing more of that in practice every single day. They're buying into what we're asking. You know, they've got a smile on their face now instead of moping around because things weren't going their way. You know, and when we play like that and everybody's attitudes are where they should be, things start happening really good for us.
Game 3 in the LIT, Trinity and Iroquois. Check out the defense from the Raiders. The rejection by Mike Bowling, bowling them over. This one was a low-scoring game. Michael Stafford hits on the 3 from the corner. Trinity up 15-10 in the second. More defense. Miracoy the steal. Dario Little, he finishes with an easy layup on the other end. Raiders down 3. How about some nice ball movement this time from the rocks on the fast break. Will lead an easy score for Raymond Spalding. Time winding down. The play of the night. Trey Ivory with the 3-quarter shot to beat the clock. The buzzer beater. It's good. Wow! Trinity and Craig Owens advance to the semifinals with a 60-45 win over Iroquois.
Ghost is really talking about defense and playing tough and playing together as a team. But Iroquois played tough, too. They played us hard. Like I said, Iroquois played us tough, and it was a whole lot to do. I had to finish on the basket a lot in the second half, and I just had to get what I had to get and rebound a lot for the team to get this win.
Last game of the night, and Louisville signee Quentin Snyder and Ballard taking on Doss. And Jalen Perry, though, gets it started with flushing down and dunk. Bruins up 4. Doss coming back. Dejon McCarley to Terrell Gray on the baseline from the bucket to cut the lead to 2. Then Quentin Snyder dribbles. He pulls up, buries the tray, giving the Bruins an 8-point advantage. Then Jamil Wilson drives to the paint. The shot doesn't fall, but Keelan Martin is there for the putback. Bruins up by 3. Then Terrell Gray here. He drives the lane, gets the nice finger roll there, leaving the Dragons down by 2. Ballard goes on to win 86-76 over Goss. They take on Trinity in the semifinals.